tais dito in one that we can in catechesis. We can pray for we present the good news to the children young as they are, because even the school are capable of dialogue, but not in a way we think an unusual dialogue, but through their experience. I think if we approach this way, our students can learn more about their faith than they can. For input, they learn faster. But if we can approach it in a dialogic way, they will understand more. So maybe for me, we have to rethink our way of communicating. And this one, second, further concern about synchronization. And he gave example that we had this form. Instead of praying, we buy medicine. But in my personal experience, what I do, yes, I have medicine. But like asking the Lord to bless the food, I ask the Lord to bless the medicine. So that the medicine will be more effective when I take it. I also ask the Lord to bless my doctor, my nurses, all those who are taking care of me, because they are God's instrument in my healing. That's what I have been doing.
Thank you, Bishop. Any other comments, questions? One more.
For me, I don't see or you know, pray that this will that this will cause our people to lose sight of God and so we can make perhaps we can make advance we can take as a project to reach out to others in the world, especially those who
It was Marshall McLuhan in 1964 who said that we are going to have a global village through science and technology. What made it popular at that time was the medium is the message. But in reality, the medium should not be the message. The point there is mediatization is destroying the culture of research in the academe, for example. Instead of studying and researching, cut and paste, that has effect on the lives of students. And unfortunately, in America, there are many universities suffering from plagiarism because of that. Now the point is, can we use the media to evangelize? Yes. Today in missiology we have what we call cyber evangelization. We have many converts from Muslim to Christianity to the internet. And they do so to protect themselves so that they embrace Christianity anonymously. They do not like to be identified or known by the Muslim brothers and sisters. Otherwise, they're going to die. There are priests, well, all of us, should use the media. Meaning to say, we are going to proclaim a message. Today, social communication is very important. But look, who are the teachers of social media? Vaishnava, for example. Her haircut, his haircut, is similar to the many haircuts in USP. Boya Buddha, Pacquiao, Madame B, and all these celebrities. No? That is why the church must be present in social media, social communication. Meaning to say, let us be there, be present there with a message. Otherwise, we are going to be our young people listen more to them than to us. So that is one point. Another point is, in your parishes there are parents, elderly or otherwise, who are computer illiterates. There is one parish I know that is offering courses to parents and grandparents so that they could communicate through the internet to their relatives abroad. That would lessen the loneliness of these people. Now, question number two about the poor. I say that from the point of view of anthropology. First of all, we are all poor. And poverty is very difficult to understand. The key to understand the concept is the word lack. Lack of. For example, I have a friend in Mindoro, millionaire, but grade 3 only. When the daughter came back from the US for her wedding, I happened to be the assistant parish priest of the place. I asked the mother, I had a talk with the mother. I said, I heard that you have many visitors. Yes, mother, many visitors. From America, from Bulacan, from Manila, from Indoor. Hindi pa kayo mahihirap ang magpakain ng maraming tao? Hindi po, Father. Magpapakatiter kami. Bakit po hindi pa kayo hihik? Magpapakatiter. What I like about option for the poor or the poor is that we have a lot to learn from the poor. Why? The poor have their own culture. And what is the culture of the poor? There are many elements that we have to study and learn from. Number one, the poor always trust in God. Number two, the poor always are in solidarity with one another. Number three, anthropologically, no, the poor will always be with us. So, let them be, not the objects of charity, of services, but let them be also contributors to the life and mission of our communities. In Mindoro, when the Germans were there, they were very kind priests. Tola, Tola, Tola. When that generation left or died, we Filipinos took over. It was very difficult to work with the people. Why? Because we had nothing to do now. And for them, we were not good priests. But today, thanks to the BEC program, the people have changed. The poor have a lot to share with us.
Thank you, Father Edgar.